would trust in an astonishing way. That's when you said, stand under this mountain, it shall be removed, and it will be. And we say, oh, you know, we always spiritualize it. I mean, you can take, there is underlying, obviously, truth, spiritual truth about that, but it was literal too. There's coming an increase of authority. You know, I told you the other day, I was praying years back for authority, and God gave me authority for a few days, which almost destroyed me. Almost destroyed my family. My kids got sick. Everything. Oh, man. You don't realize what you think. It's not just what you say, it's what you think. Mm-hmm. Because what you think will eventually come out of here. Yeah. You see? It was one of the most frightening times of my life. James 5:12 says, but above all things, my brethren, swear not, neither by heaven, neither by earth, neither by any other oath, but let your yes be yes and your no be no, lest you fall into condemnation. You see, a disciplined tongue, disciplined heart and mind is really necessary when we get to that level. You see, in heaven, words are fulfilled instantly. You know, it amazed me up there, you know. It's like a whole different world. They'd say it and they were there. They'd think it and it happened. I watched as this couple were decorating an incredible home in heaven. And I listened to them talking. And they had like a marble floor or something. And this couple was saying, what do you think about the floor? And she said, well, I can just see lovely flowers and that, and it all appeared, set into the marble, just like that. Just set in. Just think of being somewhere and they are there. The reason that happens in heaven, because there's no evil. There's no evil thoughts. There's no evil motives. So everything is instant. God is seeking for those who can trust, those who can receive. You know, once authority is given, it's given. And you know, be real careful. The gifts and callings of God are without repentance. Or without, that word repentance means a change of mind. You know, and Lucifer is not creative. He needs you.
Beloved, did you hear what Neville said? And when he was speaking about authority, the first scripture that crossed my mind was 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 19. 1 Samuel 3, 19. Many of you who have joined our prayer video or have listened to me over the years, you know that has been one of my favorite scriptures. I have talked about in prayer about it many times. That it says that God was with Samuel. None of his words dropped to the ground unfulfilled. That scripture always challenges me and provokes me at the same time. That God can walk with somebody to a point that he trusts him that ever his words are fulfilled. Now imagine if God were to give Christians, all of us, all the Christians all over the world, if God were to grant us to have such divine authority on our lips for 24 hours, that everything you say, you will have it. One of two things will happen, especially those who are not mature, baby Christians who have not yet controlled their lips. Within 24 hours, Christians would destroy the world without the devil's help. If God grant us such authority as he did with Samuel, excuse me, in 1 Samuel 3:19, that everything you spoke, you will have it. Every word that come in your mouth, God will fulfill it. I say within 24 hours, Christians would destroy the world without the help of the devil. Because many of us don't have a guard over our lips. We just have a loose lips, and I'm preaching to myself. So don't nobody take offense. And come at me and send me email or leave me comments. I'm preaching to myself. I'm just sharing with you my own personal conviction, okay? Thank you. So now back to the message. Many of us don't have such an authority with God. And many of us want to pray. And as we say it, we want to see. We want to pray and see things happen on the spot. Well, can God trust us with such divine authority upon our lips without it destroying us, with destroying us or those around us? Now, we want to pray and God heal or do something on the spot. And then 5 or 10 minutes later, or a few days later, you're using that same lips to gossip, to curse, or to do something. You can't. We have to get to the point that we have to allow the Lord to sanctify our lips. Now, one of my prayers that I always pray is, I say, woe is me, for I'm a woman of unclean lips. And because I'm a woman of unclean lips, I say, Lord, take a coal of fire from your altar. Please, Lord, sanctify these lips of clay, that my lips become an instrument of righteousness in your hand, that my lips become a loudspeaker, an oracle that only God can speak through and use for his purposes and for his glory. That's how I pray. I would encourage and invite you to pray that. If you don't want to, it's okay. But beloved, to have divine authority is going to cause us sometimes not being in some relationship, not watching some TV program. Like you just mentioned, the couple in heaven, they just thought about something and they're happy. Can we even set up our environment? If you live in a house and it's not you alone, okay, your bedroom is your own personal environment. Your bedroom may be your own personal sanctuary. Is it possible that you make sure no thoughts, no words, I mean, even you're on the phone, if you know you're going to talk foolishness, you leave the room? Like my prayer room where I have my videos, I'm not on the phone with anybody talking foolishness unless I'm on the phone praying with you. Otherwise, that room, I don't go there to talk nothing, because I want to make sure that it's an environment for God, for angels to ascend and descend, like Jacob's ladder. But back to my point, what if your house, or you pick a particular room in your house, or your own bedroom, and you make that place so pure that the glory of God can be seen, that every thought and word that is spoken in that room, in your house, in that environment, whatever section that you section off in your house, you go to meet with God, like Moses had a tent of meeting in Exodus. Or you call that your secret place to go and meet with God, and that place is dedicated and sanctified. Nothing of this world have access to that place, not even your worldly thoughts. What if you do that? That means that environment becomes like heaven on earth. That you enter that room, or that closet, or that secret place, or your prayer room, every word you say come to pass. Every thought you think, as you think, as you imagine it, it is manifested. Can we get to the point that we begin to live this life where it's almost as if heaven has been brought down to the earth? It's not only just taking the scripture and quoting it, and memorizing it, quoting it, regurgitating the scriptures and impressing each other with know the word. My friend, the devil knows the words. The devil can quote scripture. So quoting scriptures is no sign of salvation. It is time for us to get to the place that we no longer quote the scripture, but will become the word made flesh. God no longer wants us to preach a message. He wants us to be the message. So please, beloved, let us take this little message from Neville Johnson and let it begin to challenge us and provoke us. What if everything you spoke today came to pass? What if every thought that crossed your mind today become realization, or it become into reality? What if the desires, the thoughts, the words in your mouth manifest? What would your life look like? Now, if you don't want to see those things manifesting in your life, then stop thinking it, stop imagining, stop daydreaming, and stop speaking it. So, beloved, we want to have divine authority upon our lips. Then we have to clean up our lips, clean up our words, clean up our thoughts and our imagination, our desires. Go back to that scripture of David that I always pray, Lord, create me a pure heart. Lord, purify my heart, purify my motives, purify my desires, purify my intentions towards God and all men. Create me, O God, a pure heart. Keep me always from willful and deliberate sin. May sin not rule over me. May sin not rule over my appetite, my desire, my choices. That relationship with friends or with family members or with strangers or co-workers, any relationship that will wreck my destiny, let the Lord wreck those relationships. Any relationship that will cause me to offend God, let the Lord sever those ties and cut me loose and separate me from them. Any behavior, attitude of my own that is offensive to God, let the Lord deal with it. Let the Lord begin to wage a righteous war within my soul against every unrighteous act and behavior. Lord, I want to be used as an instrument of righteousness, that my presence will begin to convict sinners of their lifestyle, that my presence in my city will confront and push back darkness, that my dwelling place will become the dwelling place of the Most High. Beloved, those are some of the prayers that I pray in my quiet time, and I've shared that with you, some of you, on the video many times. Let's get serious back into the secret place, and let's start praying selfish, self-centered, self-focused prayers. Give me this, give me that, and let's get a hold of God and say, Lord, change me. Lord, put a guard over my heart that is stronger than anger. Put a seal over my lips that I don't use my lips as an instrument of unrighteousness. Cover my eyes that I don't lay hold my eyes of perversion and watch useless programs that will feed the lust of the eyes and the pride of life. Lord, cleanse me. This is Dagnet, your prayer drill sergeant. I appreciate you for listening, and I thank you for subscribing. I thank you for sharing. And those of you who say you have issue with my voice, or you didn't come here to listen to my voice, I don't know what to tell you. Go to somebody's house or channel not to hear the voice. Check your own heart. Check your sanity. Check your wisdom. I appreciate you. God bless you. Thank you.